Mussorgsky's Pictures at an Exhibition, 5. By Philip Chia. Promenade 5. Promenade 5 is the last promenade to appear as an independent movement in the suite. From then on, its theme will only appear as an integral part of the 8th number Roman tomb texture. This promenade is almost a reprise of the opening one. There are only some texture, harmony and rhythm changes. Generally speaking, the texture here will become thicker due to the addition of an octave to the main melody. Compared to the first version, the 5th promenade's rhythm marker omits the senza allegrezza marker, from Italian, no happiness thought. The latter may imply that the composer changes his mood and perspective as the exhibition tour progresses. Therefore, these two promenades must be approached and interpreted in different ways. Although the poco sostenuto mark is kept in these two markings, the pianist may choose to play the second one at a slightly faster speed, with a higher spirit. Thus looking forward to the liveliness and vitality of the subsequent movements. The market at Limoges, the great news. Stasov described Hartmann's illustration, the old women quarreled at the fair in Limoges, a city in central western France. Although this painting is now lost, Mussorgsky basically described in detail the events depicted in his musical interpretation of the original source. In this movement, the composer brings the picture to life, creating a colorful and vivid image for the noisy crowd, and the wonderful psychological portrait of Limoges' endless gossip in the market. Mussorgsky meticulously marked the ever-changing articulations in every measure of the music, on the dynamic range from mezzo forte to fortissimo. The women's high-pitched voices are delivered through the texture set in the mid to high range. The large number of sforzandi played a role in emphasizing the exclamation point in the shouts and screams of women. Analysis. This piece represents a scherzo in the ternary form, ABA prime, with a short introduction and ending. From an allegorical point of view, section A represents the gossip's introduction to the good news. The texture here is roughly harmonic, with the accompaniment on the left hand, and the right hand plays a lively melody. The only element of the dialogue in this section is in measure 6 to 8, there, the melody-changing segment is played by both hands. Section B is characterized by changes in melody and harmony materials. Eliminates the key signature of E-flat major, providing a free platform for a series of interesting harmony structures. This section is fully dedicated to portraying women's teasing disputes in a somewhat humorous way. The fierce debate culminates in measure 25, the only place in the entire movement where the texture is restored to the same consistency and the dynamics are extremely strong. Thank you. The adventure at Limoges seems to stop at the last measure of Section A prime. The gossipers' exciting debate ended with a constant repetition of the dominant chord, leaving the impression that the women failed to reach a compromise. The excitement in the coda is greatly amplified by the shorter note value, strong dynamics and texture of Martellato. The short episode seems to show that the women are packing up and chasing each other frantically out of the market. The music ends with a rising semitone, marked as poco alle rondo, proceeding to the next movement, attacca, without preparation. Eight. Catacombs, the Roman Tomb. Next in Mussorgsky's suite, amidst lively events and sounds, the music suddenly shifted to a completely different world. The excitement stopped suddenly, giving way to the image of death and cold fear, thus began the next movement, Catacombs. According to Stasov, this painting illustrated Hartmann himself and his friend Vasily Canel, accompanied by a guide carrying a lantern. The main structural role in this movement is composed of vertical harmony, which is related to long and continuous block chords. Schnittke wrote, as an expression of the reality and spirit of the human world, the movement lacks a clearly defined melody. Because the protagonist of the catacombs is not human, but the image of death. The texture in the grave is purely atmospheric, and it attracts listeners through a variety of sound effects. They are produced through sustained sonorities, sudden changes in intensity. From fortissimo to pianissimo and sforzando to piano, and unusual and dissonant harmonic shifts. These elements create a chilling surreal musical image. The movement does not have a clearly defined structure, and there is no clear basis for harmony. The only clues that may unveil a structural and harmonic outline of this movement are the rests of measures 11, 22 and 30. Essentially, the rests divide the three phrases of the movement. Although Mussorgsky did not indicate the key signature of the grave, he clearly emphasized the G key. The note that appears at the beginning of each phrase, always used two octaves of overlap, measures 2 and 23, or as part of a G major chord, measure 11.